Hello and welcome to another week of energy readings. We're looking at the week of October the 22nd to the 28th. We are moving from Libra to Scorpio in the middle of the week, and on the 24th we have a full moon. So that probably affects us all a little bit. And we will have a look at the overall energy for the week to come before we go into the individual star signs. So let's have a look at the energy of the week to come, see what's happening. Okay, so for the week, October 22nd to 28th, we're looking at the overall energy, and what we have here is the spirit of family, an ancestor of memory. So family does not have to be flesh and blood, that makes sense, it doesn't have to be blood family, related people. Family is also the people you truly love, like your best friends, people you connect with spiritually. These are all your family. And the spirit of family basically means then this week to keep in touch with some of the people. You know, be a good listener, listen to them, have them listen to you, be interactive is really important, because you have the ancestor of memory, and that means that whatever we do this week will allow you and them to create memories and to have memories of being listened to. So what I'm getting here energetically is for us to be mindful this week and to listen, right? So like I said, we're moving into Scorpio at the middle of the week, 24th or 25th, around that time. Let's have a look now at Libra as the first star sign of the week. And let's see what we got for Libra. Okay, Libra, you got the badger. And it's important, because this is your spirit guide for this week, is to remember that this week you need to be clear in how you communicate, and also if people misunderstand you, you need to realize that sometimes there are people out there who will never fully understand you, and maybe it is time for you to realize that these are not the people for you any longer, right? But be precise in how you communicate, but also notice if people just don't want to understand you. Right? Other than that, there's nothing negative here energetically where I kind of go like, there's something worrying here. I don't get that at all. It's just important, because what happens a lot when you have the badger is that you share your emotions with someone else, and people aren't really listening to you, not taking you seriously almost enough. And it's just important this week for you guys to pay attention to this and to move away from people and their energy where you're not fully appreciated, right? But that was Libra going into Scorpio, and like I said, midweek we will move into Scorpio as a star sign. So the next reading will start with Scorpio. So let's have a look at that star sign, Scorpio. Scorpio has the Arctic Wolf. The wolf is an animal that is a leader. But the Arctic Wolf of all the wolves is the one that lives in the Arctic, where opportunities are scarce and where food is scarce. So there's different rules. The rules of survival are different. So what the Arctic Wolf is telling you this week is to realize that you need to be, or ought to be, in a place where you truly lead. And here's the rub, if that makes sense, if you can call it that. Because you can lead one person, and that is you. If you are truly in charge of your life and the leader of your life, you will overcome a lot of hurdles, a lot of obstacles this week, which is really, really important. So this is not about leading a group of others, even though the theme for this week is spirit of family. This is really about being in tune with yourself and realizing that adversity can be overcome. Okay, that's Scorpio going into Sagittarius. A obviously we're here in a forest, so as you can hear, there's other people. Not everybody is as happy as we are. Here we go. So we're going into Sagittarius. You have the peregrine falcon. And that means that whatever happens to you this week, you will see it. Things that come to you, you will be able to see it. So there will not be any surprises where you kind of go like, whoa, didn't see that one coming. So be vigilant. But because the falcon has a very good eyesight, you will be able to see what you need to look at this week, right? So that was Sagittarius going into Capricorn. And I feel that it is for Capricorn that we brought here the solar plexus singing bowl. So pay attention to your emotions this week. Really, really important to pay attention to your emotions. Let's see what you got. Here we go. Makes sense because you have the Dancer of Promise. And it's important that when people say something, they should always follow through. They should always follow it up. Don't be lied to. Don't be a person that people say like, yeah, I'm gonna do it, you know, when I get around to do it. If people owe you anything, make sure you claim it. And, you know, tell people when they do you wrong. That's really, really important because this week, like I said, your emotional core is a bit vulnerable. And so you have the Dancer of Promise. And that basically just means that when people are pussyfooting about stuff rather than really living up to their potential around you, or they promise you something they haven't done, it's really not your job to remind them all the time, but it's time that they get this done. Otherwise, you're not being taken, again, we had this earlier, fully seriously. So pay attention to that, okay? So that was Capricorn, and now we're going into Aquarius. Aquarius have got the groundhog. It's a very straightforward message. It just means that you need to reflect whether or not your life is too repetitious. If all you ever have is the same stuff, and that means the same stuff happening to you, you could change jobs, you could change partner, you could change situations. If every single time the same issues find you, then obviously there are lessons that need to be learned, and they need to be learned now. That's what the groundhog is here for, is to say like, there's too much repetition here. Okay, so that was Aquarius going into Pisces, my favorite star sign because I am Pisces. Let's see what's in there for us Pisces this week, October 22nd to 28th, and we have the great great horned owl, and that means that us Pisces, for all the Pisces here, we need to just make sure that we listen well, right? Listening is the key this week, and us Pisces, we really have to listen what's going on. Also, owls are super. What's the word? They survive everything. You know, they're clever enough. They just figure stuff out. So you will figure stuff out. But the key to it is listening, or another way of saying it is reading between the lines, right? But that's important. So far, I can see quite a pattern here already for the star signs, which is that this week it's really important to be vigilant to being taken seriously, and say something about it if you feel you're not being taken seriously, right? So that was Pisces going into Aries. Right, Aries. This is going to be a week where you have the Shaman of Sorrows. It just means that this is going to be a week for you, Aries, to realize that there are things that still sit inside your soul, for want of a better word, and that need to be released. So this will probably be a tearful week for some of you. But tears are sacred medicine. Let them flow. Don't be alarmed. I also get the feeling for Aries, you need a lot of red, you need a lot of grounding. A lovely bath with some rose petals, for instance, would be awesome, just to get that out and let that flow away, if that makes sense, right? So that was Aries going into Taurus. So Tauruses have the Arctic fox. The fox mainly denotes that you Tauruses are really old souls. You have been through a lot of things and you always come out top, if that makes sense. But because we have the Arctic fox, again, the Arctic denotes an area where just being clever is not enough. There's loads of stuff where you will struggle to find food in the Arctic. So the idea here is to realize that you are an old soul. You have survived a lot of heartache and difficult situations, and you need to also just pay attention how much of a survivor you actually are. Always remember that at the end of the day you will find a way, right? So in other words, if you're too worried about stuff, that's not going to really help you. So keep your energy high, that's important, and things will not deteriorate, right? So now we have Gemini. Good week for Gemini. You have the hummingbird, and the hummingbird, just like the kingfisher, is one of those birds that no matter how crooked the tree is, and the tree represents your life, the hummingbird can work it. In other words, no matter what life throws at you this week, you'll manage. Really, really important for you to realize that you manage. I'm aware that there's some sort of a helicopter flying around here. You will probably be able to hear that. So there's nothing wrong with your computer or anything. It's just the noise that is on the recording, right? So that was Gemini. And now we're going into Cancer. I know whose sign that is. Mm. Yeah. Let's have a look at Cancerians. We're looking at the week of October the 22nd to the 28th. No, the 20th to the 28th. The 22nd, no, I'm right. 22nd to 28th.
Yes.
Let's have a look. Right. For you Cancerians out there, really important, you have the Dancer of Fear. And that just means that there's a lot of stuff that you have to contend with that wants out, that wants to be released. But sometimes when you release stuff, you feel empty. Because you kind of go like, wow, you know, what's going on here? And all the guides are saying to you, don't be afraid of releasing stuff that doesn't necessarily help you, and let stuff go. This, because you have the spirit of family and the memory of ancestor of memories, a lot of that, what that really means is a lot of the stuff that you will be looking at is old stuff. Trauma that has been sitting there for a long time. Also with regards to family members putting it there. Right? So that's important for Cancerians. Going into Leo. Before we move into Leo, I've been given this image that, again, I said that earlier, that red is the color for you to look at, being grounded. And I talked earlier about taking a bath with the rose petals. I'm getting the same image for Cancerians.
No, Leo.
No, before I move to Leo.
Oh, sorry.
No, okay. I haven't moved to Leo yet. So we're still with Cancerians. So before we move to Leo, that's what I've been given for the Cancerians too, that you should be grounded. The color red is important for you at the moment. And having a bath with red, which means rose petals or something like this, will be good. And be surrounded by red a lot this week, right? And now we're moving on to Leo. Right. For Leos this week, there might be some trouble ahead, in the sense that, and again, this is the theme this week, where people are not giving you the due credit, and where you're not being taken seriously. And for Leo this week, you need to hold your head high. And remember that oftentimes, nothing you do or say is wrong, it's just people perceive it in a different way. Just hold your head high. Without being argumentative, You have the mule deer, which is an animal with antlers, because I got the male version here. And that means you're quite protected to stand your ground, if that makes sense. But the most important thing is to hold your head high this week, right? That was Leo going into the last star sign for this week, which is Virgo. And like I said, we're looking at the week of October 22nd to 28th. We have a lovely full moon on the 23rd or 24th, somewhere along those lines. And this full moon is a moon that says to you, you know, you're going through things, but it is a great energy change to actually prepare for changes that are positive to be permanent, right? So don't be afraid of the full moon this week. Yeah, and that's obviously, that's not just for Virgo, that's for all of us. And now we're looking at Virgo. Okay, Virgos need to have a little talk with themselves. You need to, right, have a little tap on the shoulder and say to yourself, I'm awesome, I'm all good, because you have the Osprey. And that just means for you Virgos to look at how much progress you have made. Look at the positives. Look what you have achieved in life, rather than feeling shite, right? Nothing really works for me kind of thing, because that's not the truth. Always look at what you have achieved already, right? And that's all we have time for this week, right? Thank you so much, and I'm sure we'll see each other very soon. Bye.